Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. It has been very quiet seismically in the previous time frame. Actually, as I explained in previous updates, since August, because the last magnitude 7 earthquake occurred on 17 August, which is now over 100 days ago. So let's have a look what we actually had in the previous time frame. Here on the SSGI graph with magnitude 5.5 and larger earthquakes, we see some clustering at the start with the convergence of critical planetary geometry on the 19th and 20th, as expected, but no large earthquake. It stayed actually at 5.7 at the Greenland Sea. Then we had this convergence on the 22nd, which is really a critical convergence. And we see a seismic response later on the 23rd with a 5.9 in the Fiji region. Again, it didn't reach magnitude 6. Then we look at the end of this time frame, and we actually see, following the lunar peaks, remember I explained in detail the lunar peaks on the 24th and 25th, because usually we see a seismic increase following those lunar peaks if they follow on critical planetary geometry, as we had on the 22nd. So we do see this 6.1 near the west coast of Honshu, Japan. It's the only magnitude 6 earthquake that we actually had in this entire time frame. So if you look at averages, we say well, we have a magnitude 6 earthquake every 3 days on average, but that's not reality. And this is a perfect example. We can have 20-25 days without a magnitude 6 earthquake. It's rare, but it is possible. So this tells you that the averages really do not reflect reality. It's really important. We have to do the observations, and we see this single magnitude 6 earthquake actually on the 26th. And remember, I said around the 26th, we could have a large earthquake, but it stayed at the low 6 magnitude range. Then we had two magnitude 5 earthquakes, 5.7 and 5.8, a day later on the 27th. There's also some clustering there on the 26th, 27th, which is what we usually see. So no large earthquakes, and yes, the Earth is in seismically quiet period since August, and averages are really low. So let's have a look at the next time frame. We see Sun, Venus, Neptune coming up tomorrow in a conjunction. No, that's actually today already, as we speak, basically. And then we have a lunar peak. That's Moon, Earth, and Uranus in a conjunction. Now, Sun, Venus, Neptune, that's something to be aware of. Well, sometimes when Venus aligns with outer planets, we can have a larger earthquake. And we count about 2-2.5 days from the moment of that planetary conjunction, and then we would end up around the new moon on the 1st of December. There is a slight possibility of a larger earthquake, but Sun, Venus, Neptune there is on its own. Mercury is not involved, so I say a slight possibility. We have Moon, Earth, Jupiter also on the the end of the 1st of December, and we often see some seismic increase after the Moon aligns with a gas giant, certainly Jupiter and Saturn. And then we talk about the 3rd, around the 3rd of December. And then we see planetary alignments, planetary conjunctions coming up. That's Sun, Mercury, Uranus on the 3rd, Mercury, Earth, Jupiter on the 4th. That deserves some attention. I will come to that in a minute. And then Sun, Mercury, Earth on the 6th, and Sun, Mercury, Jupiter also on the 6th. There is a near quadruple conjunction coming up. I will explain that in the next update. But we see there on the 6th a convergence of critical planetary geometry coming up that will extend into the 7th, and I will discuss that in detail in the next update. In the solar system, we see indeed that Mercury, Earth, and Jupiter are closely aligned, but not currently. This is today. But we also see Venus and Mars. So I drew two lines here. These are electromagnetic energy vectors, so to speak. And you see that Earth is really close between those two lines, or near those two lines. And that is going to be significant in the next 2 weeks. We may see a seismic increase as a result. And Venus and Mars, Earth will be between them later on this month. And there could be an obvious seismic response, especially because of the lunar geometry with Venus and Mars, with right angle geometry coming up later. That's in the 2nd week of December. But we may already see a seismic increase coming up because of these two electromagnetic energy vectors where Earth is really, really close. Especially Venus and Mars. We should really pay attention to that. So like I said, back to the SGI graph, on the 6th, We see this convergence coming up of critical planetary geometry, but we are already close to these electromagnetic energy vectors. So I do expect some seismic increase, probably more than what we had in the previous time frame. If we look at atmospheric fluctuations, it was really quiet in the atmosphere in the last week, but we picked up some fluctuations yesterday. And interestingly, they made sort of an X if we include the antipode line. And we actually see over Western Europe near Portugal, and also that's the X that it actually makes with the antipode near Italy. And it goes over Africa and then to the South Africa, close to the South Sandwich Islands. And if you look at the other side, it's really interesting what we see here. We have a fluctuation to the north, that's near Alaska, Aleutian Islands, and to the south, that's Fiji, down to New Zealand. And if you look at the other fluctuation, it makes a cross again. It goes to the west, that's near Kamchatka, and to the south again, Fiji, Loyalty Islands perhaps, and again to the south, close to New Zealand. That's the only fluctuation that we had yesterday, the last couple of days. It's not a guarantee, but this is an interesting observation, and according to these fluctuations, there could be a seismic risk in these regions. We will continue to monitor the atmosphere, and you can see the latest updates on the website and in our social media. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.